On Your Health Tonight, the first drug to slow the progression of Alzheimer's disease now has full approval from the FDA. Here to answer questions is Dr. John Dickson, a neurologist in the Division of Memory Disorders at Mass General. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, the drug is known as lecanemab, or by the brand name Leqembi. Now, the company stresses it's not a cure for Alzheimer's, but doctor, what can you tell us about the possible benefits of taking it?
In the clinical trial of this medication, the main benefit was that there was less cognitive decline at 18 months in patients treated with the medication compared to placebo. So this suggests that lecanemab does slow the rate of cognitive decline in patients who have Alzheimer's disease pathology in their brains. However, as you pointed out, it does not stop the decline in cognition completely.
Okay, so I don't need to tell you, more than 6 million Americans are currently living with Alzheimer's. So any idea how many patients could potentially do better with this drug?
It's difficult to know at this point with certainty, because a lot of the estimates we have of Alzheimer's disease rates are based on clinical symptoms alone. And because of the way lecanemab works, only patients who have a protein that's called amyloid beta in their brains are likely to benefit. And this makes it difficult for us to know without testing for that specifically. However, there are some estimates that up to 30 patients who have a clinical diagnosis of Alzheimer's disease may not have amyloid beta deficits in their brain. So another factor to consider is that the effectiveness of lecanemab has only been shown in patients who have mild cognitive impairment or mild dementia due to Alzheimer's disease. There's no evidence that patients who have moderate or severe Alzheimer's disease might benefit. It's also important to consider possible side effects, which include bleeding or swelling in the brain. And approximately a third of Americans are expected to have a gene variant that increases that risk. So with all these considerations, it's difficult to come up with a specific number, but it is probably substantially lower than 6 million.
So we've learned that Medicare will offer insurance coverage now that the drug has full FDA approval. Why is that important?
It's very important because the current price of lecanemab is listed at $26,500 a year for treatment. So that would be prohibitively expensive for many people unless it's covered by insurance. And because Alzheimer's disease is more common after the age of 65, the majority of people who would be using this medication are Medicare beneficiaries. And Medicare coverage will be extremely important to make sure that we can minimize disparities in access to this medication as much as possible.
Understood. Dr. Dickson, thank you so much for joining us today.
My pleasure.